taking the fuel tank down to fix these lines on it. And I noticed a wet place on the strap, which has rippled up the rubber liner on it. On the strap part. And I knew what was going to be. The gas tank's got a hole in it. Rusty place, scab on it. So I've drained the gas out of it. Down below the hole. And I'm using the Permatex gas tank repair. It's an epoxy combination of two liquids and two pouches. That's really good stuff as far as fixing stuff like this. Small holes anyway. So I'm going to take some brake cleaner and thin out any oil or extra gasoline. An area about an inch and a half in diameter around that rust patch. Then I'm going to take some 80 grit sandpaper and sand off the paint and primer at least a half inch in diameter around the rusty surrounding of the hole. Now if you've got a little bit of gas keeps weeping out of there, they ship putty with it that you can plug the hole with if it's too big of a hole. But I prefer to leave the hole raw so that the epoxy can go up in it and kind of flare out on the backside like a tire plug and seal it inside as well as the outside. That's kind of a bad location because the strap puts extra stress on the patch. The patch will be higher than the rest of the tank and that'll make more pressure on the patch that could stress it and crack it. We'll keep it as thin as possible. Okay, I've got an area at least half inch in diameter cleaned up around this hole or series of holes, rusted out place. I used a brass brush to do some cleanup, fine tune it. This is brass, so it won't generate any sparks. The sandpaper was actually aluminum silicate, aluminum base, and you know, that all the fumes coming out of that would be just right for a spark to light it off and take you, the vehicle, and whatever you're working under or inside of out. Be all over. It's just fairly dangerous. People will take it for granted, but this can be hazardous to your health. But the holes are nice and defined, and that epoxy will stick around this. I'm going to degrease it. The repair kit comes with an alcohol swab to help get any residual stuff, especially from the brake cleaner I used on it. Might leave some residue on it. As I say, I wouldn't use any type of steel or any materials that would generate a spark doing this, because any source of ignition from the fumes coming out of that will be detrimental, possibly. It's not worth it to risk your health, life, over too much to get something done. This is the kit here. Comes with a two epoxy pouch. Just bust one in the other and keep mixing back and forth for 2 minutes until the color is consistent. Come with this fiberglass cloth to reinforce it and to cover larger holes, and some sandpaper if you don't have any better. An alcohol prep pad to clean the surface before you apply this epoxy to it, and a brush to apply it with. The stuff does heat up. That's how you know it's good. When it heats up, makes it bite on good. First thing I want to do is get an idea of the area to cut this fiberglass mesh out and stick in there. Just want to cover the bulk of the rusted out place, but not run it all the way to the edge, because you want your epoxy to go out past this cloth and feather it smooth or almost thin, paper thin out to the ends. Looks like about a half a piece of this fiberglass, about half the width of it, edge of my finger long. And take a pair of scissors or a razor blade and cut a square out of that, more or less. Yep, there's a square I cut out. I opened the alcohol prep. Now all you have to do is just squeeze one bag into the other and mix it back and forth until both of these are one color and mixed up real good. It'll start getting warm, and you got about 6 minutes after that to, it says 8 minutes total. I'll put one layer on of this epoxy, then I'll put that fiberglass cloth on, and then another layer of this epoxy over top of the cloth and feather the edges out around it. When I mix the epoxy up, I'm gonna cut the end of it open and dump it into this container that the stuff came in, so I can brush it out of it. Alright, I want to bust the pouch. I'll just mix that up. Okay, it's all mixed up. I'll push most of it up into the side with a slope on it and cut the end off of it and dump it out into the container. Nice. I'm gonna put this underneath the car. Got my patch in there with the stuff. Got my brush under here. I got the container tilted up so the stuff leaves in the back of it. Take this alcohol swab and wipe the rusty place off. Get plenty of it up in that hole. Stick a patch on there. Spread some more over it. Anyway, that should stop the leak. Yeah, that's good enough. Better leave it alone.